नमस्ते स्टूडेंट, सो टुडे इज आवर टॉपिक इज अमेंडमेंट्स लॉ एंड एवोगैड्रो लॉ. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टू डिफरेंट गैस लॉज, अमेंडमेंट्स लॉ एंड एवोगैड्रो लॉ. बॉयल्स लॉ एंड चार्ल्स लॉ वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल टॉक अबाउट द अमेंडमेंट्स लॉ. अमेंडमेंट्स लॉ इज एग्जैक्टली सिमिलर टू द चार्ल्स लॉ. Exactly similar to the Charles law. If you have studied the Charles law, then it becomes very easy for you to understand the Amenten's law. Now, according to Amenten's law, at constant volume, the pressure of a given amount of a gas, is increased or decreased by 1/273 of the pressure of that gas at 0 degree Celsius with every 1 degree centigrade rise or fall in the temperature. Clear? So the statement is almost same that of the Charles law. So our statement is at constant volume, the pressure of a given amount of gas, increased or decreased by 1/273 of the pressure at 0 degree Celsius with every 1 degree centigrade rise or fall in temperature. Clear? So, चार्ल्स लॉ में हमने क्या लिखा था? एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर. हेयर इट इज एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. देन इन चार्ल्स लॉ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ गिवन अमाउंट ऑफ अ गैस, हेयर द प्रेशर ऑफ अ गिवन अमाउंट ऑफ अ गैस इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज बाय 1/273 ऑफ द प्रेशर एट 0 degree Celsius विद एवरी 1 degree centigrade राइज और फॉल इन टेम्परेचर. सो टेम्परेचर अगर आपका इंक्रीज होगा, सो जो आपका प्रेशर है दैट ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस बाय 1/273 ऑफ द प्रेशर एट 0 degree Celsius. एंड इफ टेम्परेचर डिक्रीज देन प्रेशर ऑल्सो डिक्रीज बाय 1/273 ऑफ द प्रेशर एट 0 degree Celsius. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वी गेट द सेम इक्वेशन, दैट इज Pp इज इक्वल्स टू P0 प्लस P0 अपॉन 273 इंटू T, where Pt is the pressure at T degree Celsius, P0 is the pressure at 0 degree Celsius, and T is the temperature. Clear? And if I rearrange this equation, if I take P0 as a common, so inside I get 1 plus T upon 273 or P0 273 plus T upon 273, and this we have studied in our previous video that 273 plus T in degree Celsius, according to Lord Kelvin scale, it is T in temperature in Kelvin. So it comes P0 into T upon 273. Clear? Now here P0 is a constant, 273 is also constant, therefore we get to know the equation that P is directly proportional to T. This we have done in the Charles law with us. This we have done in the Charles law in detail. So if you have studied the Charles law, it becomes very easy for you to understand. So Pt jo hai wo P0 plus P0 upon 273 T के इक्वल हो जाएगी, और P0 आपका क्या हो जाएगा? कॉमन. सो 1 प्लस T अपॉन 273, इन दिस वे गेट दिस. एंड सिमिलरली चार्ल्स लॉ में हमने पढ़ा था एब्सोल्यूट जीरो टेम्परेचर. व्हाट इज एब्सोल्यूट जीरो टेम्परेचर? अ हाइपोथेटिकल टेम्परेचर वेयर वी कंसिडर दैट द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गैस इज जीरो. एंड सिमिलरली इफ वी पुट -273 व्हेन टी इक्वल्स टू -273 डिग्री सेल्सियस देन पीटी इक्वल्स टू P0 plus P0 upon 273 into -273, that is equals to P0 minus P0, that is equals to 0. So at absolute zero temperature, both pressure and volume of the gas are supposed to be 0. So it is basically a hypothetical temperature where we considered that the प्रेशर एंड द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गैस जो होता है वो हमारा क्या होता है जीरो. एंड थ्रू दिस वी कैन राइट द मॉडिफाइड स्टेटमेंट ऑफ एमिल्टन्स लॉ. एंड द मॉडिफाइड स्टेटमेंट ऑफ एमिल्टन्स लॉ इज एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम द प्रेशर ऑफ अ गैस इज directly proportional to the temperature in Kelvin. In Charles law also I have told you that it is necessary to write whether the temperature is present in degree centigrade or it is present in the Kelvin. If it is present in the Kelvin, then we get this equation. And if the temperature is present in degree centigrade, then we get this equation. So that's why you have to write that whether the temperature is present in Kelvin or the temperature is present in degree Celsius. If you write here Kelvin, then it becomes wrong. And if you write here Celsius, then also the statement becomes wrong. Clear, beta? Now, because pressure is directly proportional to temperature, so when we plot a graph between pressure and temperature, then we get a straight line. But we didn't get the straight line from the origin, क्योंकि जो -273 degree Celsius है, above that temperature only the gas liquefies, यानी इस पे हमें कोई भी गैस नहीं मिलती है. So we get graph like this, means from above of the origin, not from the origin, slightly above from the origin. Clear with us? I hope Amundsen's law is clear to you. Okay? And because P is directly proportional to T, so what we can write as P is equals to K into T, where K is the proportionality constant, or P upon T is equals to K. P upon T equals to K. So, if we change the pressure of any gas from P1 to P2 at temperature T1 to T2 at a constant volume, then we get P1 upon T1 is equals to P2 upon T2. हमें क्या मिलेगा? P1 upon T1 is equals to P2 upon T2. So, this is the formula which we have used in the numericals. Clear? Now we study the Avogadro law, which we have already studied in the first chapter of the 11th class. So, Avogadro law. According to Avogadro law, equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure possess equal number of molecules. Clear? It means Avogadro's law जो है, वो किसके बीच में relation बता रहा है? Between volume and the moles of the gases. So, equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure possess equal molecules of the gases. So, according to Avogadro law, the statement is equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure possess equal number of molecules. It means V is directly proportional to N at constant pressure and temperature. दिस इज द एवोगैड्रो लॉ. ये हमारा क्या है? एवोगैड्रो लॉ. दिस इज एवोगैड्रो लॉ एंड द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द एवोगैड्रो लॉ वी हैव स्टडीड इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन द डे. सो हियर दिस इज sufficient that what is Avogadro law, what is its statement and the equation. So V is directly proportional to N. Now we will do the numerical which is based on the Amundsen's law. So here is the question. A steel tank containing air at 15 atm pressure. There is a steel tank. Ek steel tank hai jiske andar air hai aur uska pressure kitna hai 15 atm at 15 degree Celsius and the temperature is 15 degree Celsius. Is provided with a safety valve. उस टैंक के साथ हमारा क्या है? सेफ्टी वॉल्व लगा हुआ है. That will yield at a pressure of 30 atm. जो कितने प्रेशर को होल्ड कर सकता है? 30 atm तक के प्रेशर को होल्ड कर सकता है. So to what temperature must the air be heated to blow the valve? तो हम कितने टेम्परेचर तक एयर को हीट कर सकते हैं कि आपका जो वॉल्व है वो आपका सेफ रहे. Clear? So volume is same. Now volume is constant here. So pressure is directly proportional to temperature and P1 upon P1 is equals to P2 upon T2. हम ये apply करेंगे. अब P1 यहाँ पे क्या है? 15 atm. P1 is 15 atm. T1 is 15 degree Celsius. But इस equation में this temperature, ये जो temperature है किसमें है? Kelvin. So we'll convert 15 into Kelvin, that is 15 plus 273. Now what is P2 here? P2 is 30 atm. 30 upon T2. So T2 is equals to 30 into this becomes 288 divided by 15. So here it's 15 to the 30 and then 576 Kelvin. So we can heat the air up to 576 Kelvin. Hum 576 Kelvin tak air ko kya kar sakte hain? Heat. So in this way the numericals are very simple. So do the numericals based on the Amundsen's law, and we have already done the numericals based on Avogadro law in our first chapter of the 11th class, so no need to do the numericals of the Avogadro law. If you already know the numericals of the Avogadro law, do more and more numericals of the Amundsen's law. So there is a question in your screen based on the Amundsen's law. Solve the numerical and tell me the answer in the comment section. So that's all for today. I'll see you in my next video with a new topic.